correlation does not imply causation. You all know that. I suppose at this point you are able to identify the corresponding confusion or famous fallacy post hoc ergo propter hoc. The question we are going to explore now is why. For what reasons correlation does not always imply causation? There are three main cases. Firstly, you may have had the causation the wrong way. Secondly, there can be a hidden variable that you may be missing and that is affecting both variables you are studying. And finally, it can be a mere coincidence. We'll provide a few examples for each situation. First, wrong direction. We'll use the windmill metaphor, a classic illustration. We observe that when windmills spin faster, the wind blows stronger. Therefore, windmills cause the wind. In other words, they are in the end actual wind factories. Put that way, it looks so ridiculous that you wonder if people make such claims. But trust me, it happens more often than not what you believe to inverse the cause, the direction of causality. That is the reverse causality issue. Second situation, there's a hidden variable or third factor. It refers to extraneous variable that you have not necessarily thought of and that correlates with both the variable you are trying to explain and the explanatory variable you have selected. For instance, let's study the impact of living near high voltage lines on the odds of getting cancer. If you search online, you'll probably find some graphs showing that the closer you live to such lines, the higher the probability to develop a cancer. It is quite unlikely that we are in a case of wrong direction. Having a cancer gives you the will to live near power lines. Well, it is understandable that people explore the hypothesis like living close to those power lines, high voltage lines, give you cancer. After all, there's a strong electromagnetic field around it, and it's not crazy to suspect that it can impact your health. However, before jumping to conclusions, there's a couple of variables you might want to look at. Incomes, for instance. We can expect that houses that are located near high voltage lines are cheaper, and that therefore they are occupied by people with lower income. And do you know that what probably increases when your income decreases is the odds to get cancer? Because the lower your income, the more difficult it is to sustain a healthy lifestyle, to eat healthy food, and so on and so forth. In the end, it could increase the risk that you get cancer to have lower income. So this consideration does not alone dismiss the idea that cancer could result from electromagnetic fields from the power lines, but it cannot be considered at this only possible information, and the data do not show that there's a causation. You need to collect additional data to compare the differences in terms of relevance of different explanations. Often in France, when we refer to hidden variable, we speak about the stork effect, because we notice that villages with the largest amounts of storks were the ones with the highest birth rates. Shall we conclude that storks bring babies? I think not. Maybe, just maybe, the larger the village, the more nesting sites, and the larger the village, the larger the population, hence the number of births. Last but not least, coincidences. If you want some examples, there are websites for that, such as spurious correlations, with most surprising correlations you may think of. Let's take an absurd one. There's quite a strong correlation, did you know, between the number of movies Nicolas Cage appears in and the number of people who drown in pools. And trust me, watching Nicolas Cage movies does not make you want to kill yourself by drowning. Well, as far as I know, at least. This is just a coincidence. And just keep in mind that sometimes there's no need to search every time for a causal link or for a hidden variable. There are plenty of spurious correlations in this world, and some are statistically significant. And with the increasing availability of large data sets with numerous variables, it is quite expected that we will find weird patterns. It is in human nature to look for such patterns. Even when sometimes they are not meaningful, this trend is actually a cognitive bias. It's clustering legends. Be aware of it. So, wrong direction, hidden variable, coincidences. Now you know why correlation does not imply causation necessarily. And I have no doubt you will meet the postdoc ergo propterog fallacy a couple of times in the coming weeks. Remember about that video when you will.